our content at rebelloveshow.com. I am Rob Mathias.
And I'm Shire Dude.
And today we have the one and only seditious sirens of my rebel mistress and free love.
Renee Cake.
Renee Cake.
Call her by her appropriate name.
Well, I'm sure there'd be a Renee Cake left on the table by the time the show's over.
Oh, speaking of, where are the cigarettes?
Yeah, we should move the cake closer to
her. Yeah, how's she going to reach that?
Hold on. I'm going to light one right now.
For those of you not watching the cam, the Renee Cake is a little, it's like a Tupperware filled with coffee grounds that we use as an ashtray here in the studio.
Slash air freshener.
Every time Renee's over, at the end of the day, it's all filled with just her cigarette butts. That's her secret ingredient. So, yeah. And if you're going to want to watch this live, go to rebelloveshow.com, click on live, and you can catch the webcam if you're in LRN chat right now.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be a special night for the cam, especially during the breaks.
Oh, yeah, because we have a whole new setup for the studio. We worked very late into the night rearranging everything. I like the way it turned
They're
out.
They're fancy. I was sleeping.
We got all sorts of, new angles that I'm trying out, and you can see all that on the cam.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I think it's pretty cool.
I like it. I like the way it looks. It, you know, it's a podcast radio. They don't even see it. That's why they should go to it or watch it on YouTube. Anyways, it's been a busy week.
Right. Oh, there's been literally something every day since our last show.
I'm like in the Twilight Zone right now. I don't know what's going on.
I mean, every night there's something that we've done, mostly social, but...
Right.
Yeah, nonetheless, I mean, that's one reason I love living here.
Well, yeah, in Manch Vegas especially, there's going to be...
Well, I feel like we started... started off with Cop Block. It's a new season.
That's right. We did do... That felt like a social thing, though. That didn't even feel...
Yeah.
We were Renee and her heels. Okay. Rookie mistake.
Oh, you went straight to that. You went straight to that.
Guys, don't go cop blocking in heels. I think that's the lesson learned, right?
I mean, there's appropriate attire, and she almost had it. Like, we were in our cop block bandanas.
We look sexy.
We look good.
Oh, yeah, you guys look sexy.
And then we held a sign. Renee made her own sign a couple hours before. And
I sure did.
I'll put the pictures on Seditious Sirens, so you go
Atta
like
girl,
our Facebook
why
page.
Haven't you already?
But Renee made her own sign, and then I found a sign later that said avoid police. I liked it. It was very direct, you know?
Yeah, no, I loved it.
You gotta tell people why you're out there. Like,
I just liked mine because it was filled with pretty colors.
Dude, that was like a red and black sign. I'm not gonna talk shit, but later.
Yeah. Well, I am surprised you made it throughout the night in those heels.
I couldn't have completed that look without my heels. Heels make your butt look good. Like it was a butt night.
Okay. You have to look good if you're gonna be cop
exactly.
Locked. I mean,
well,
come on.
Hey,
now.
Come on. Like if you're gonna be getting people's attention on the side of the road, what better way to do it than with a good looking blonde with a nice ass holding a nice, pretty, full, colorful sign?
I am not
That'd
a blonde.
Be me.
But you
I
know,
mean,
I was there looking good as well.
I rolled an ankle. Fuck it. It was worth it.
She did.
It was worth it. I limped all the way home.
She didn't make it the whole night. We're like walking up and down because no activism is complete without getting drunk. I think we all can agree.
Oh, I love drunk activism.
So after cop blocking, we usually get drunk. I remember
we pregame for that too.
We pregame and then we cop block and and then we go get drunk after. And Renee didn't make it to the after part.
Yes, I did.
Yeah, she was there.
What? In fact, I was there before any of you guys because I couldn't walk anymore.
She had to crash early.
Yeah, she couldn't take it.
Yeah, but she didn't eat with us, and that's the best part.
Oh, no, yeah, she crashed early.
Did you go
early.
To Red Arrow?
No.
Then I don't
Shire
care.
Dude here live streamed us at USA
Sugar. Oh, my God, we need to talk about
Unless
that live stream.
Unless you were at Chipotle or Red Arrow, I don't give a fuck.
No, that live stream is life.
No, that was fun.
Oh, man, the live stream was fantastic. So I live streamed that night for... almost 3 hours, and just with Bambuser, and I did the checkpoint at first, and that was cool. We went up and down the bridge a few times.
It turned into an impromptu Rebel Love Show live,
but 3 hours long.
The second that you three showed up, it turned into like this like Rebel Love Show esque thing, and even all the LRN chat room people like jumped in. And in the LRN chat room,
it was cool. It was like they were out there with us.
Yeah, it was really cool. It was really cool. And we got to answer their questions, like, live. And
about
like
polyamory.
We would do on the normal Rebel Love show. Yeah, we talked about polyamory for most
while
of the time.
While we were cop blocking.
We were at
No, that
USA.
Was why we were eating USA chicken and biscuit. Yeah. So if you want to see me stuff all my food in my mouth, I don't.
You guys answered those questions really well. I think.
Yeah, with a mouthful of cheese.
None of it was planned, obviously. You know, it was all just live us. It was really cool.
I think that's the first time polyamory has ever been discussed during a cop lock of a DUI checkpoint in history. But that's never happened before in the world of internet activism.
I'd say
that's
a safe bet. We're out here making history.
I actually also got one guy who, like, rapped on there, too.
Oh, my God. Yes, that was awesome.
Yeah, and you can check all of that out if you go to ShireDude.com and just click on the live stream section.
I know,
most recent video.
I know you. I'll be honest.
Who thinks we should just make a reality show? Lauren chat room.
We already.
This kind of is a reality show.
Yeah, like this is us, people. Like you, if you ever.
But would you have the world see it? Would you put it on MTV?
I would.
We already put it on. Online as it is anyways.
That's online, though. I've been
talking about for a year putting this on public access, and people have pressured me. And I'm a lazy slacktivist, so I haven't done that yet.
Put it on Channel 8, man, and Keen.
Well, I have an agreement with a few guys out there, too. You know, I'll put their shit on out here if you know, they put mine in on Keen. I just been lazy, not going up to it.
You need to not be lazy. Well, Shire Dude needs to send that a live stream, and that can be the first episode of the season.
Send that to where? Like,
to
like,
public access?
Yeah,
public access TV.
Yeah.
That'd be pretty interesting.
Yeah, you could put those live streams up as a.
Yeah. I mean, if I get fired now, I mean.
It's certainly long enough.
I got to live my life, you know? It's 3 hours.
They
could do some good stuff. But you gotta. The only problem with that is, what if they edit, you know, stuff? You know, people are so.
Well, yeah, I think there might be. I mean, depending on what time of the day it's on, I think if it's later at night, you don't have to do as much editing and censoring.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure late at night.
Everything happens on reality shows. People are like having sex left and right. That'll be us, basically. Orgies.
That already happens. It's just not on camera
yet.
Yeah,
but no one films it, you know?
Oh, it's filmed.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Oh, well. I have no comment.
I mean, neither do I. Oh, it's been a great week. But no, I'll say this. During that live stream, though, you definitely convinced me that I'll join in a live stream in the next DUI checkpoint. So like they can go to your site and you can get multiple angles and stuff like that.
As far as I know, in the past year, I'm the only Manchester activist to have live streamed anything.
Yeah,
since
what?
I got here. Yeah, and that's like terrible. Like a bunch of Keeniacs have Bambuser and use it regularly, and I think that's something we should emulate here in Manch for sure.
What else would you want to see live stream besides like DUI checkpoints?
Well, I had an idea for a show that was it's kind of the same thing, except it's just like a Wednesday night show where you go out and you actually like intentionally cop block, so you have like the police scanner on you and you respond to incidents and you're just live streaming the entire night.
Wow.
You should call it cops.
Cops or cop blockers.
Ambulance chasers.
Cop blockers or
no, just cops.
Oh, okay.
Just cops.
Fuck IP.
No, unless you're Rob and I, in which case cops are ambulances.
No.
Vice versa.
What?
No. We already almost cop blocked an ambulance, but we did because it was an ambulance.
Aw. You guys are slacktivists. I mean, if you're going to do something, you got to commit.
Nah. Basically, we were fucked up and we were in the car and we were coming home and we just saw the lights and we were too scared and we went to pull up
Rob,
the camera.
I was kind of joking. I was joking with
Rob
her about
hates
it.
Rob cop blocking. He does.
Yeah.
What?
I'm not a fan of it.
It's not his kink. I'll tell you what is, though, when we come back.
Oh.
On the Rebel Love Show.
Oh. Every day you make investments. investment decisions.
Yo, my headphones are up way too loud. I don't know if it's just the volume on anybody.
Yours?
She can't adjust the volume. And the
potential longevity
of the United States. Yeah, you should be able to turn it down. Hey, babe, it's not a mic.
I'm not even.
Are you sure?
Oh, no, I don't think you can on yours. Hold on.
Hey, if you're viewing the cam, make sure you get in that chat room. I'll answer any of your questions.
Ooh, Cecil is in the chat room.
Ooh.
The easiest thing in the world for a reader to Kickstart do says he that one on reading. That one Friday when Renee did that Barney meltdown Kilgore, in the LRN studio that is not one for a reality show.
What? Where is it?
In the chat.
I'm in the chat. I don't see any of that.
All right, hey, I want to turn your. Can you put your headset on? I want to change it right now.
His paper is one of the few that people now pay good to read online. Someone else
other way
the internet just restarted. Realized
that attention is fragile. Motown Records founder Berry Gordy in the
talk 60s again.
1 2 test test. Okay, hey Renee, all right, cool. Hey babe, where's the lighter at?
Why do you guys want so much from me? You guys are mad needy, bro.
We ain't mad needy. Yeah. So is the hey chat? Are you guys excited about the creamy D we're about to lay out there? Because I know I am.
They should be excited, man.
I mean, this is a. Oh, we're coming back in a couple seconds. Hey, what are we talking about next?
You're the host.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
To learn how you can put our programs sure on the air in your area. You can
have LRN. Yeah, that's too soon, dude.
Yeah.
We really need a show clock, guys. So if you can go over to Rebel Love Show, hit the donate button and send us some bitcoins. You can actually buy a clock and know when we're coming back from this break.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Gosh.
I'm turning this up.
Hey, it's our commercial.
They make me think. They really make me question the values that I have been taught as I have grown up in this
mean, mistreating world.
Plus, I really love the cooking segment.
If you want to know what life is like in the Manchester, New Hampshire activist scene, the Rebel Love Show is the premier choice.
The Rebel Love Show is the Dogecoin of Liberty Podcast.
Rebel Love Show is a good show, and it's liked by all the young people who like sex with strangers and have lots of body hair.
I don't usually listen to Liberty Podcasts, but when I do, I tune into the Rebel Love Show. The smooth baritone voice of Rob Mathias just does it for me.
Me too.
And I find that shower dude oh so charming. So if you're like me and want to keep a finger on the pulse of the Free State Project without actually moving to New Hampshire,
how many Doge does it take to buy a show clock?
That's a lot of Doge.
Show at RebelLoveShow.com. That's Rebel
I'd say a quarter of a million.
.com.
The three most important
send him all your Doge.
I say,
for the love of God, just send all the Doges so we can stop talking about Dogecoins.
Maybe even like a fifth of a million Dogecoins.
You must have so many Dogecoin by now. You've like increased its value.
How many Dogecoins do you have?
Well, I got that half a million Doge donation. Very generous supporter.
What is that, like 50 cents?
No, that's more like $60.
Make sure you get $5
a month at the AMP program at amp.lr. I was almost a Dogenaire, but I spent some of it. And please don't knock over the studio table. Thank you.
Jesus.
God damn. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living. Can't hold her liquor. Oh no, wait, she hasn't had liquor tonight.
And connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today.
Oh, by the way, we're not live on LMR.
Really?
Look, every time I hit connect, you can connect it says invalid username and password. I already have it set up correctly. I don't really care. But
that's Facebook. That's unfortunate.
Yeah.
Hopefully they figure that out.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And we're talking about some of the socialist things going on here in Manchester. And Shire Dude here, he's been the maestro of creating like cool events as of late here in Vegas. And we went to one on Thursday. What did we do Thursday?
Thursday, oh man, Karaoke, right?
I love how you don't remember.
I had to think about it because it's just been a blur of a week.
So much karaoke. It sucks for Nate. We need to get her a fake ID, guys. Send us some Bitcoin. It doesn't work anymore because she dyed her hair blonde and now no one believes her fake.
Oh, no.
So we need to get her a blonde fake ID. Or she needs to dye her hair back.
Or she needs to get a brunette wig, right?
Yeah.
Something needs to get.
Brunette wig. Just cover it up.
You have so many years ago. Like, we can't even. We got to, like, put you under our shirts or something.
I know.
It's not complete without the cake.
Yo, anyway, does anybody out there look like me? Like, get on the camera right now. See if you look like me. And if you have an old ID that you're not using anymore, then send it my way, man, because I could use it probably more than you could.
Yeah, just help us out, man. We're just trying to party over here.
For real.
Yeah, I know.
Anyway.
I know. Anyways, yes, a lot of karaoke, a lot of drinking, a lot of fun.
I sang Spice Girls.
Yeah, I can't believe you guys did that.
Why? Because we were awesome.
It was pretty awesome. It was you, Ellen, and Cecilyn.
It was me, Ellen Stallone, and Cecilyn. Does Cecilyn have a stage name?
Cecilyn.
Yeah, that is it.
That's her stage name?
Yeah.
I want to call her Sparkles Glitter Kitten Part 2.
What? Why did you call her that for?
Why is it Part 2?
Part 2, because you're Part 1, Shire, dude.
Aww.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You are Sparkles, the pansexual kitten.
Oh, man.
I listened to the show.
We're digging that one back up.
That's like 4 Shire years ago. Mm-hmm. I forgot about that.
Hardly remember that.
Oh, that was an awkward moment.
Oh. Yeah, right. Well, whenever the moral of that story was, whenever you tell someone that you're against labels, they, you know, they just like, oh, so you're and then they label you.
You do really dislike labels.
Literally every
like,
time.
I'll be honest, you have been consistent in that decision, that viewpoint of yours for as long as I've known you.
That's
right.
Good.
You never have agreed with labels.
I think the concise way to put it is that labels are great in advertising, but in any kind of real conversation you're having with someone, they're completely useless.
Yeah. Don't confirm.
Okay, so if you're advertising this show, what label would you put on it?
The Premier Polyamory Anarchy Podcast.
Okay.
It is the, like, what other polyamory anarchy broadcast is there out there?
What if there's like a million? Did you guys even YouTube it?
I seriously doubt there's anything like this.
I mean, there's polyamory shows out there, but they're usually more, they're like, mostly like poly shows that are out there, to my knowledge.
They aren't anarchists.
No, of course not. I know.
They're just not anarchists yet.
Yeah.
Yet. Okay.
Yeah, in my opinion, like, polyamory is very anarchy because you're,
also called relationship anarchy.
Yeah. A lot of people use that for it. There's people that believe in like relationship bill of rights type of stuff, where like pretty much everything that like voluntarists and anarchists believe just like put into a relationship oriented situation.
I mean, I feel like it's people who already think that way anyway. They're thinking towards freedom. They're more freedom leaning. It's easier to, you know, nudge them that rest of the way.
Oh yeah, yeah, for sure. But at the end of the day, like most liberty shows that are out there are pretty much talking about what it means to be free and why you should be free, and what the government's doing to prevent you from being free. And poly shows are pretty much the same thing. They're pretty much educational style shows. I mean, they'll talk about stories of, like, you know, people on the show that are regulars talking about their lives and stuff like that, kind of like what we do from time to time. But they don't really they don't go into like more detail. It's more so like how to handle a situation or how to do that.
Yeah.
Where it's like how you talked about how like there's the poly panel at Pork Fest, and then you're doing the poly party. Like,
right, those next are, level.
Yeah, those are like level one. Most, pretty much from all the content I've seen of like poly podcasts and shows are pretty much like level one stuff.
Okay.
Or maybe
right.
level two, but it's like it's more so like, you know, a support mechanism for people that are poly.
Renee, are you going to the poly party?
I am, because I'm poly curious.
You're poly curious?
Oh, man.
What?
You heard it here first, folks.
This is big news.
I don't get it.
But you're curious.
I guess. I don't know. I've kind of like dabbled in it before, but.
What don't you get?
I'm not. I mean, you are so.
Three out of four people at this table are poly.
I mean, I don't believe in labels.
Oh, God.
Ash, too. Ash is here.
Ash is poly.
Ash is poly as shit. She has more partners than I've ever seen anyone have.
I feel like if I could pick one, like, sexual label, I would just call it a free lover. Like,
you know.
Isn't that ironic?
Free lover.
I know.
More labels.
I don't know if it's like a label. I like all the labels. Like, I don't want
to. You like all the
I don't want to like just be gay or just be kinky. Like,
she's
or
a polyamorous.
I want to be everything. I feel like I am.
Oh, you are, babe. You're everything to me.
Well, thank you.
No. Fucking get a
okay,
room.
Okay, so what are you?
We do.
We have. With you
it doesn't
in
really
it,
matter what room
change.
We're in. We're
what
always in a room.
Yeah, it doesn't matter if I'm not in the same fucking room. I can still hear you from outside. Jesus.
Wow.
Oh, Renee.
Shire Dude knows my pain.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyways.
Yeah.
What are your questions about polyamory?
Yeah. I don't know. I don't really have any questions. It's just...
You know, just gotta remember, okay. It is contagious.
It's highly contagious.
This is a highly contagious mindset.
Well, yeah, I didn't start that shit till I came out to Manchester.
Oh,
but
here's a good question.
Oh my God,
what's more contagious?
Renee Polly.
What's more contagious?
Chickenpox or Polly?
No.
Okay.
becoming libertarian / anarchist or becoming polyamorous?
I'd say polyamorous because Polly is based on love. Right?
Uh-huh.
Solely on love. And granted, while my brand of what people would call anarchy or voluntarism is based on love and like, you know, I'm anti-war. That's where I come from.
Yeah.
A lot of people's anarchy and voluntarism would be based on hate for the government or hate for being controlled. And I think something based on love is bound to spread farther and faster.
Oh, man, that's beautiful.
Oh, it is. You're beautiful.
Do you think?
Thank you.
Do you think poly could be like the gateway drug for anarchy to like
no,
all
I
these
feel
people?
Like,
I hope so.
I feel like it's easier for people here. I feel like if you are in a normal everyday situation, like people are curious, but people aren't like so. People always have doubts and they second guess themselves. But if you're introducing it to someone who's already like in this community, of course they're gonna think about it. They're already thinking freely. You know, I feel like it can't. One has to be a gateway for the other. But I feel like anarchy comes first. I don't know.
No, I hear you on that. But at any rate, Renee, you have a support here if you ever want to go. You know,
we're
here to discuss for you. You can come on the show and talk about your issues of like. You know, what's why you, you know, what issues
I think
going
you
poly.
Should just think, like, try to see if you like, you know, like anyone.
Have
first.
You been in a poly relationship before?
Well, I mean, I've been in an open relationship. Like, I've had one primary, but I've been with other people. But every time I would be with other people, I would feel bad. Like, it just didn't feel right.
So, what was Because
you were just sleeping with other people.
What was the nature of the open relationship where you, like, told. That your primary, what you did?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
You still felt bad about that?
Yeah, and he was like, it's fine. I was like, that's a problem that he doesn't care. I don't know. It's fucking weird.
Huh.
More about Renee's sex life
when we come
back.
Hi, I'm Derek J.
Hi, Derek.
I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death.
Yeah, would you start dating?
I know, you need to date.
I mean,
you can't even think about politics because you need to just date.
Far cry from what could be provided for
no. No, non like date everyone in
hey,
the
where's
world.
The bong at? Someone might smoke.
It's right over here.
We pass that along. Thank you, sir. All right, what are we hitting next?
The bong, apparently.
Apparently. Dum, dum, dum.
It's from the bong.
The Empire doesn't require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Due to an upturn in the economy, Main Street Business Loans has pre-approved the release of millions of dollars in small business funding. Your business may already be pre-approved to receive up to $250,000. We've sent out millions of pre-approval letters. We see the economy growing.
Oh, hey, no bullshit from the chat room is saying that the swinger thing does not work and it goes against reality.
Being a swinger?
It's not realistic, he's saying.
What is swinging?
Yeah, see, I don't...
You need to pull out those poly dictionary terms.
Gotta pull out these poly definitions, because I don't really know what swinger... Like, what do you mean by swinger? I guess just sleeping with multiple people.
You should message Old Girl and ask if he can get the...
I mean, we should clarify. We should clarify that.
Hey, yeah. Apparently your sound is coming through. According to both Derek and Joe, your sounds are coming through bad.
I feel like I'm kind of crunchy sounding.
How's that?
Here we go.
Is that better?
Hello.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's a little better.
All right, I turned the compression up on you.
Oh, yeah, I thought it was just my voice.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks, guys, who are listening for sound quality. Anywho. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow moving. You know, Polly isn't really swinging in that it's multiple serious committed relationships. It's not just you're having sex with everyone.
Yeah, anyone can have sex. Sex is sex.
If you can't listen to the Liberty Radio Network's internet stream, you take a lot of selfies. You take weird selfies. You make a weird facial. Why do you smile like that? I mean, I smile weird too. Don't get me wrong.
How are you critiquing her selfie?
I'm trying to help her out. I want people to want to have sex with her. I'm trying to help her out.
People are going to want to have sex with her anyway.
I understand that, but I'm just trying to rationalize me critiquing her Snapchatting.
Oh, there are plenty of polystatists out there. If you're in like a poly Facebook group, you'll definitely see them.
Yeah. Here, like, belly right peace, freedom, like, you gotta hold it higher. See, that's a constructive snap.
try and get the curvature of your breast in the shot too.
Definitely.
I mean,
hold on, don't go out of the camera though.
A little
higher. Why don't you take the snap right here behind us? We'll put it on. Oh, right there. There you go. Take a snap like that. Perfect. Perfect. Wait. Just turn a little bit. Just turn. Oh, keep turning. Keep turning. Keep turning. A little bit more. A little bit more. A little bit. Hold it. Hold it. Just keep holding it. Wait. He's almost got it. Hold on.
Jesus.
Okay.
Go.
Now snap.
You just made that so hard. What the fuck are you doing? Oh. Some kind of shenanigans. Jesus
Christ. Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, and we got the seditious Snapchatting free love here. And,
hey boys.
Fuck out of here.
And my rebel mistress. You guys want to share your Snapchats for the LRN crowd?
I didn't fucking get any.
You can join, you can find Renee at, I don't even know the name of your Snap.
Dude, neither do I. And what I'm not kidding.
What is it? Is it Renee underscore cake?
No, maybe. I literally it should don't be. Know what it is.
You know, you can,
I don't think that's it, actually.
We're going to make one.
Isn't it like Ignoring Authority or something like that?
It's really crazy, too, how...
how that was her old Snapchat. She changed it.
Rob, you dick.
What?
I didn't get any good selfies because you and Shire Dude were too busy.
They're selfish. They don't care.
If you're,
and I'm trying they don't to send care this about your to snap. A hot Tinder guy, and you're fucking. And now my
you heard
is
it,
dying.
People. Renee Kate,
God damn it,
is on Tinder.
If you were watching the,
if you are
the
on
break,
Tinder, you better try to your hardest to swipe.
Yeah, swipe right on her. If you're watching the live feed. We got Shire Dude doing his magic and zoomed in just perfectly on the snap. It was
so
beautiful.
Is that going to be bonus content?
Oh, that is bonus content.
No.
If you're watching the cam feed, then you're seeing all sorts of crazy bonus content, especially during the breaks, especially during the long break, especially during this episode.
Our long bong hits, you mean?
Yeah.
So weren't you guys talking about poly definitions, extortionist dude?
Extortionist? Poly extortionist? What?
Oh, the extortion story. Last episode. I have a follow-up on that.
Oh, well, do tell.
So in case you missed last episode, let me see if I can sum this up really quickly.
Oh, go for it.
Somebody accused me of stealing footage that I had filmed with my camera and my own two hands.
Oh, yeah.
And then extorting her for it. And the good news is there's the follow up is that somebody actually bought that footage off of me for the person who accused me. I'm glad it's getting used. It's almost 2 gigabytes of actually, you know, pretty interesting poly information. And I actually got money for the day of filming that I put in.
I was in that room. It was hotter than this room.
Yeah.
And what did we do to go celebrate this poly victory?
Dude, I don't remember. This week has been a blur, like I said.
We went to the poly.
The poly karaoke.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So lately these guys have been experimenting on the FET life.
Fet life, yeah.
Yes.
FET, what's that?
Oh, God. Fetish. Poor Renee.
Oh.
Fet life.
We're gonna damage her ears.
I don't want to know anymore. I'm good.
Okay.
Aw.
Renee.
Renee cake. Well, anyway, so this one was actually good because we've been to one that was in Nashville. That was pretty fun, but there wasn't anyone there I was really interested in. And we went to this one, and I was like, I'd fuck her.
There's some hot chicks.
Them together and him. Like, it was a pretty good meeting. And I wasn't even drunk.
There were some cool people there. Unfortunately, they only do that meetup like once a month or something.
Yeah.
I was tired of karaoke, though, by that point.
You're tired of karaoke.
I was. Like, I can only do so many Britney Spears
what?
Songs.
How can you fucking
Well,
get
you're
tired
not there,
karaoke.
Renee. What am I supposed to
Look,
do?
Look, I understand because I, like, actually have, like, some vocal talent. Unless I have just eaten, as Rob knows.
Yeah. I snapped the hell out of that. That was fun.
You did not.
Oh my! Yeah, I did.
No,
I said like
you didn't.
I recorded like five different songs. You did.
No. Yeah.
Yes.
Where did you put it?
Oh, it's on my Snapchat.
I never seen.
I might have saved a couple of them, so don't worry. Maybe someday I'll release it like on my raw
if
YouTube
you're
channel.
Good.
If you're good. If you're lucky. You better behave.
No. See, Rob,
and like it.
This is you know. This is why you're a rotten human, you know?
No.
How am I a rotten human being? That was fun. That was Snapchat worthy.
I want to find the snaps them.
No, 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 no,
and
I got
ANCAP Gadsden flag right behind you doing it the whole time.
Wow.
It was like
you
liberty,
know,
like
you can't,
weirdness
you can't.
Gold.
You realize you cannot talk about this long on the show and not release it now.
No, no.
During the break, I'll find to see if it's saved on my phone or not.
There you go.
And then I'll play it into the microphone.
No.
So, Renee can't handle the reality show, is what she's trying to tell.
This is reality. What do you want? If we had a reality show, this would happen.
This would be on
our
MTV.
Snapchats would be on Bamboozer. Like
Renee's adorable.
I'll be bullshit.
She worries too much.
God damn it.
She should let the world see her adorable face.
God damn it.
Well, okay. I don't bite, Rob.
You don't bite?
Oh.
What?
No, I said something that day. He, like, took a photo of me, and I was like, don't release that or I'll bite you.
That's so exciting.
That's a violation of the nap, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, I was violated.
Well, I mean, apparently anything can be a violation.
Well,
a nap,
it got me to stop taking photos of said person.
Although, isn't it only a violation of the nap if Rob doesn't want to be bit?
But I don't want to be bit.
I thought you liked that.
Oh, babe, you know I love to be bit.
Oh, God, you fucking guys.
No,
we are pretty open about our when we are around each other. It's very fascinating.
Because
people like, you know, Renee here, like goes a little wild about it, you know?
Well, I mean, don't get me wrong, like.
This is why you should be polyamorous. This is what's polyamorous.
Well, hold on, Anne. Not everyone who's poly is kinky as shit like you guys, okay?
Are we that kinky?
Yes, you are. Yep. Like, you call yourself, like, vanilla compared to, you know, where you were, like, what, a year ago. But I still think you guys are kinky as shit, especially compared to me. I'm pretty damn vanilla.
I mean, yeah, compared to where you were a year ago when you were, like, fucking 5 dudes. I don't know. I feel like we're normal. I don't know.
Are we normal?
Yeah.
We're just living our lives, baby.
I don't know.
Everyone else is just judging.
I think you've just gotten used to the kinks.
Yeah, probably.
And so that's why you're like, I'm normal now.
There was a time in my life where I was having threesomes on a regular basis in so many drugs. But it was a good time. It was a good time in my life. And, you know, I was like, I need to find someone who I can enjoy all of that with and, you know, share my life with that person.
I thought that's me.
I did. I found you.
Mm-hmm.
Look at us.
And let me tell you, we partied.
You should stop smoking so many. Oh my God. So we went, we started at Church of the Sword.
This was this last weekend.
This
correct?
Was, it was the 50th anniversary. Sorry.
No. 50th? That's incorrect.
No, no, not even like what was 4 or 5 years.
It's the 5th. The 5th year. Okay, that makes sense. it was the 5th anniversary, and it was my first time ever going. I had heard about it. I've seen pictures. People like have duct tape swords and they fight each other, but we missed that part because Rob, so lazy.
Oh, you got me
always getting drunk with Shire, dude.
You got me back
every night.
We get drunk every night.
Every other night.
Yeah, every other night. Not every night.
But anyway, so we missed the beginning half of Church of the Sword, but we got there just in time to do some illegal shit, which was great. I love starting the day with a felony.
When the ceremonies of Church of the Sword up at Area 23 is you basically because the state, it's illegal to sell liquor without a license. So you basically buy a beer for $1
from your neighbor. It's like communion.
Yeah, and then buy it back and forth, and then you all drink.
and everyone just sits around and gets drunk on Sunday morning.
Would an act of civil disobedience is part of the what you do at church. It's a fun church. Yeah.
They say what was it? They aim to break more than 3 felonies a day, and I feel like that really started off our weekend because we really aimed to break lots of laws. Like we aimed, we accomplished.
Oh yeah, yeah, we did good.
We let church inspire us.
It was inspirational day.
And you could get up there and you could do rants, and that was so cute. People did different rants or poems, and then Rob got up and did a rant.
Yeah, I did a rant. Which was cute. Yeah, I was nervous to do so. Because there's like 40 some people and there. I mean, I knew everyone, but nonetheless, right here there's cameras. There's not 40 people in the room. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And I got up and did this rant about the federal government, and then announced the Bruins Edition event Foundation for New Hampshire Independence is doing that I'm running, which we'll talk about when we come back.
All right, I believe this is the long break, correct?
Oh, no.
Is this not it?
No.
It's the bottom of the hour.
Yeah, you gotta wait.
Or is it the top of the hour?
You gotta wait. Yeah, we come back in like 3 or 4 minutes.
Oh. Okay.
You're fucking lazy. Don't you want cigarettes?
All right.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on doing the Priestly Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With 4, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar.
What is it?
Hey, you can use Derek's saying your audio is still a little wrong.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals,
computers. Just take it.
Take it.
Home and garden,
bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware.
What was it? What was it?
A piece of ice.
Hey, dude,
why would
you
give me a piece of ice? I know it's hot, but get all your shopping
done. Get a portion of your purchase. All right, come on.
Are we back?
No, I need to test your audio. Derek's saying your audio ain't that great.
Mic check. Mic chickadee check. This is Shire Dude from ShireDude.com. ShireDude.com for all of your video... For all your videographer needs, ShireDude.com. Okay.
You're good. Try it now.
Mic check.
Oh, my God. You're tenfold better.
ShireDude.com.
Hey, if Joe and Derek, you're listening, thank you for the help with that. I appreciate it.
Rob's lying. He didn't Snapchat you. Via the Keen Vention blog and Facebook,
so stay tuned there.
Oh, thanks for reminding me.
And, God, fuck both of you. Tickets are available now. No, it's terrible.
Wait, I think I... please tell me I saved this.
Please.
Please tell me.
Reserve your tickets now at
keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. Which one is this?
Did you know that you can listen to LRN.FM 24/7 via our free-to-air satellite channel? From Mexico to Canada, our signal covers nearly all of North America. All you need is a view of the southern sky.
Hey, guys, we're coming back in a second.
A dish as small as 30 inches. There are no monthly fees. Learn more at sat.lrn.fm. Plus, if you're a broadcaster or want to be one, this is a good delivery method for our content. See our coverage map.
I can't.
Sat.lrn.fm. That's SAT.
We're coming back like in a second.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road.
No, the long break's coming up in the following. So besides Bruin Sedition, what do you want to talk about? For this good
deed, Ross may be
you know,
have a show for
we can go into the creamy D.
Am I on here? I can barely hear me. Mic check. Hello, there we go. That was weird.
I do have notes, but you know what? We kind of wing it.
Get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears.
Banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And, when we left off, we were talking about...
the Bruins Edition event, correct?
Yes. So I'm a board member of the Foundation for New Hampshire Independence here in New Hampshire. I kind of put my minarchist cap on for a second and try and somehow promote smaller government. I know, it's crazy. But at any rate, not that I... at any rate, I'm hosting an event... at Abel Ebenezer down in Merrimack. It's a microbrewery, and we're having a Bruin Sedition event down there. Pretty much one of our board members will be doing a talk on why secession is a good thing, and after that, it's pretty much a meet and greet for people that support New Hampshire independence, kind of so that everyone gets to know each other and kind of build like a strong community for that. And who doesn't like sedition, and who doesn't like good beer? So that's what I announced at Area 23, which was pretty cool in front of a
I personally
bunch of people.
Find sedition sexy.
It is.
That's what I've
very
heard.
Sexy.
Yeah.
That was an easy setup.
And we're seditious, therefore we are sexy, right?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's going on down, that's June 3rd, 8 p.m. at Abel Ebenezer. If you are in New Hampshire, please go to that. That's I'm hoping for a big turnout for that. Especially blow out the last one, which I wasn't involved with. So I kind of, that's my goal is to beat those numbers personally.
Nice.
Yeah. So anyways, the Creamy D.
Oh,
all right. We
yeah.
should probably talk about
Certainly.
Michael W. Dean here for
are
just
you,
a second.
Are you going to leak the Creamy D?
No, he leaked his Creamy D all over my Facebook page.
Oh my God.
Gross.
He's posted it. Yeah, he's posted it in a few different places.
Yeah.
So it's only appropriate that you let everyone hear.
Well,
I mean, other people already shared it. You might as well continue.
So he thinks we're on the right track promoting liberty in the world of polyamory.
Right.
But he doesn't think he thinks we need to take it to the next level.
I agree.
All right. You agree?
Rebel Love Orgy next spring.
Oh, geez.
So here's the setup.
Said that's a bunch of Bitcoin that might happen.
Y'all should get one of those tents at Porkfest.
Oh, we're going to have a tent at
the
Porkfest.
The Rebel Love tent.
So
Rebel Love Dome.
Creamy D of the Freedom Fiends. He used to have a podcast called Coffee and Submission.
Yes.
And one of the episodes of that podcast was him having a threesome. And it's like audio only, obviously. And you hear Creamy D, you know, having sex with two chicks, and it's actually pretty fantastic.
It's pretty hot, actually. What? Yeah. I can't lie. Yeah. You're going to hear it, Renee.
He shared it with us recently. What? So.
Oh. Yeah, no. Yeah, you're going to play it, aren't you?
Not only are we going to play it, but during the commercial break, we're going to have the camera set just on you to see your facial reactions.
Please, yes.
So if you're not tuned into the cam feed, you should definitely be tuned in by now.
And if you're not turned on, you will be soon.
So he wants us to do something crazy like that.
Yeah, he basically wants us to record ourselves audio-wise. Well, good audio, mind you. If it's not good audio, we might as well not even do it.
But only threesomes, or I don't understand.
Well, it has to be sex in some form or fashion or another.
Like,
it can be like a series.
If you just recorded an audio of your sex all the time, like, I feel like that would get a little creepy.
Well, I mean, if you knew you're on camera, or at least on, you know, on mic, you probably would act out a little bit better.
It sounded like he hit that mic, you know?
He definitely did not. He definitely did not, because after the fact, they talk about it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I didn't finish.
It's not just that one clip.
You got me
clip.
Too riled up. Couldn't finish it.
So
I think it's very interesting. I think,
Creamy D was tapping.
Well, that's just like a regular episode. There's not even bonus content.
So should we do what he's saying and just like put out, you know, sex audio podcast to promote liberty?
Well, I think...
Should we have sex for liberty?
Should we have sex for liberty? Hashtag.
Like, as interesting as it is, you know, poly isn't just about sex, right? And, like, we're talking about...
Anarchy's not all about the sex either.
We're talking about being more like a poly show, and, you know, which is interesting because that just kind of happened. It's not really something we planned.
Absolutely. That is so weird that we didn't plan
this
to
happen. The show's about your life.
I mean, the show was created before I even was poly.
I mean, polyamory is a type of rebellious love, and we just happen to be the Rebel Love Show.
I know.
Oh, snap. Mm-hmm. You're getting deep there, brother. Okay, are you going to play this audio for Renee or not?
No, we're waiting for the break. I didn't want to disturb LRN listeners with the...
Yeah, we might get banned from... would I be bannable? Releasing a sex tape of another host of a show on LRN, live on LRN. We're not getting us banned off of the network.
I don't think so at all, especially since we're such a late night show. Like, yeah, call me old fashioned, but 10 p.m. is pretty late night for me.
I know.
Please, you don't sleep.
This is correct. I'm all over the place.
Yeah, you always listen to some crazy stuff too from time to time. You know, you're probably going to start looping this sex tape. We're going to, like, me and Anna are going to fall asleep listening, hearing Creamy D over and over and over.
No. That's what Shardy would do. That's pretty hot. I'd probably get turned on from that.
No. He's going to start using it as an alarm clock, so whenever his alarm goes off, it's going to be Creamy D.
Play that trick on each other, Renee. I can't wait till you move in.
See, that would be a good alarm clock.
We used to play that trick on each other, and we played Shardy's favorite song.
Oh my god, yes,
no, which, you know, his favorite song.
Oh no, yeah, that's right. Yeah, I think didn't I start that with you guys?
No, you started it.
We haven't done that in a while.
He said he was gonna wake us up, and that's what he woke us up.
Yeah,
I'm still gonna use that from time to time.
I played Shrug by Objectives Girl, and that was really ridiculous.
So, if you ever
like blasting like loud in the clock. Morning. I've never seen Shardy get up so fast and turn something off. He was like, absolutely fucking
nope. It was pretty funny.
I would too. I'd throw something at it. I couldn't. I'd probably break the fucking whatever it was that you were playing it with.
Hey, you gotta give her credit. She makes a great alarm clock.
That's true. That's true.
You know?
Jesus. Wow.
So, Creamy D, I think maybe down, not yet, maybe down the road, we'll dabble, maybe.
You guys should get Creamy D on this show.
I would love to have him on.
I want to see where the magic is made, you know?
Yeah, I'd love to have him on at Porkfest.
We'll have to talk to him about that.
Definitely.
That'd be cool. I mean,
yeah, Porkfest, man.
Oh my God.
Less than a month away now.
Get Creamy D and Derek J.
At the same time?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Two of the fiends.
We should just do that and steal it from them.
Dude, we're already going to have a kick-ass show.
That's true.
Oh, yeah. You guys are going to be live at Porkfest, right?
We'll be live Thursday at 10.
Thought it was 3.
3.
it's sometime during the day. At some point, you'll record. Yeah,
but the
important
part is that we're wearing bikinis.
That is the
during the show?
Part.
I am in prime
during the show.
Bod. So
I just joined the gym, so I will be
We got like 3 weeks, man.
I know. I gotta make a count.
I already kind of gave up trying to get in shape by Porkfest.
No more fucking energy drinks. No more fucking beef jerky.
Well,
I
was in a bathing suit this weekend, and you were pretty damn impressed, just saying.
Get me wrong. Don't get me wrong. Yeah, Facebook had to see the photo. Like, that was, yes.
So, if you want to see that at Porkfest, just saying. Come see the seditious
signs. And you're trying to get away from what we're both trying to tell you. Listen to Renee.
Shakes. No offense. You're not like fat.
I don't know about protein
shakes.
I'm not down on that. But you got to. You dropped that the other stuff though. Baby.
You dropped the ball a little bit there, and fucking energy drinks on the daily fucking dunks. Y'all are both gross.
No,
you too, asshole.
What's wrong with dunks?
No, there's a lot fucking wrong with dunks.
Thank you.
Why you wanna talk? That you're eating shit food, and you eat meat all the time.
You guys should just go on a Chipotle diet.
I'm basically on a Chipotle diet. I have Chipotle like 3 times a week at this point.
We had Chipotle for
breakfast. I'm on a green diet. You guys had Chipotle for breakfast?
Yeah, we had to share a bowl because we're both broke.
We didn't have enough cash on us.
I took all the money this morning.
And then the girl who was working there comes over and she's like, oh, you guys are sharing a Chipotle bowl? That's so romantic. And we just looked at each other like, Chipotle, where the magic is made.
Oh,
hashtag polyamory.
As I work at Beloco, which means I'm cheating on Beloco. I can't even be poly with my food sources. I can't cheat on Starbucks with dunks.
No, like, you are being poly. It's not cheating as long as it's okay with all.
Yeah,
all
as
those
long
I'm pretty sure they'd be okay with
I'm sure they're not consensual. I'm not sure though. I don't know.
No.
Yeah.
No, Beloco would be mad.
Like, I work in the coffee industry. I get coffee everywhere.
No, you don't.
Yeah, I do.
Despise coffee.
You hate
from
Dunkin'
anywhere,
Donuts.
Okay, well,
Dunkin'
Donuts in particular is terrible coffee.
No. Let me tell you something. I love Dunkin' Donuts.
It sucks.
And
if you want to know how much, watch the season finale of Shire.
The first thing I saw when I got off the plane in Manchester was a Dunkin' Donuts. I was like, you know what? I'm home.
Ew.
Ugh.
Cato University is the Cato Institute.
Are we going to play it?
All right.
We're going to play it? Play it. Let's play it.
Dogecoin is going to the moon, by the way. Anyway, I hope you folks are ready for this. We're going to have the reaction video.
No.
All right, here we go.
Are you killing that vibrator again?
Yeah.
Kill that vibrator.
Pass me the bong.
Watch me masturbate, y'all. Good girl.
Why? No.
Put it back on. Put it back on.
We should play this during every break, every long break. What do you think?
No, this is horrible.
Sniff my armpit, pet.
What? This is literally almost making me gag.
This is good stuff.
This is disgusting.
This is like...
This is horrible. They sound like fucking Yoko Ono.
All three of them?
The two girls sound like fucking Yoko Ono, okay?
Good girl.
I really hope that my sister's watching this right now.
Do they think this sounds good?
Yeah, it's pretty hot.
No.
I love Daryl's soothing voice in the background.
I'm gonna put Daryl over it.
So
silver is trading at $16.
That just changes it entirely. Gold is
valued You're so at $1,192
per ounce. And according to Bitcoin, the average price of Bitcoin
is $2,000.
This is Ellering Gold.
Antiwar.com reports on Saturday the U.S. Senate failed to get a deal together on the NSA surveillance.
Someone said on the USA this is Freedom a sheep.
Act, a watered down reform
bill. And someone should copy them.
The body then went into recess. It's not recess for the pro-surveillance leadership in either the U.S. House or
this
the
is
U.S.
the worst.
Senate, as both sides are scrambling to find some way to get those extra three
Jesus
senators
Christ,
on
man.
Board before the June 1st deadline. The Senate has already talked about
is it over?
Vote Sunday the 31st, hours before the deadline.
No.
And
any someone said, is Ian having sex in a tutu again? No, that is not. No.
Is that it? Is it over?
Yeah.
That would make it likely to convince anyone with House leaders talking up additional protections.
Look at this awesome art by Lucy Bamboo.
Isn't that awesome?
Yes, sir.
Maybe there's liquid on the floor. Just squirt over here. What is this?
Wow. Well, there you go. That was the coffee and submission podcast.
That was fucking
that was
traumatizing.
Amazing.
That was
wow.
Awesome. It was like we were actually there, you know? It was like a 3-day experience.
You know, it had really good audio.
Yeah.
Really good audio quality. And this was done years ago.
You could hear everything. Like, I could hear, you know, her tonsils, like, yodeling.
Man.
It sounded like Yoko Ono. Those girls sounded like Yoko Ono. Did they think that they sounded good?
I mean, I'm sure they weren't worried about it because they were fucking.
Give me the bonging, baby doll.
Who tries to sound good when they're fucking?
I do.
Where's the bonging?
I make a very good effort to sound
good. Well, obviously, you're not into the fucking because she can't be. You can't control that sometimes.
Yes, you can. Or maybe I just have good vocals? I don't know. Like,
Jesus.
I try to keep it down for the most part in the first place, but like.
No, you gotta let loose and just let your body take over. And then the moans come naturally. And then, you know, sometimes you sound like a sheep. But that's pretty hot, you know?
No.
Well, no. I don't know. Everyone sounds literate.
That was.
This was a rebel. And he wrote.
No way.
Through the Shire. He's from Illinois. This rebel boy.
What was that? Was that Anne?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
That was Anne singing my anthem.
The Ballad of Rob Mathias.
Wow.
Dude, I think the Rebel Without a Pause should be your theme song.
Rebel Without a Pause.
The rhythm, the Rebel Without a Pause. I'm lowering my level.
No, Rob's so much cooler.
Hey, you know, I bet you Method Mall would make a Rob Mathias rap if I asked him. I bet you he'd do it. He's the guy who rapped during the live stream that I did during the checkpoint.
Yo, do we have a fucking phone charger? Because I'm trying to text Hot Tinder Boy here.
I actually might be able to play that.
You can if you grab my vape, you can use my charger over there.
What?
What's going on, man? He's just muting people willy-nilly. Gosh. You bitch-ass motherfucker.
Bitch Mountain, Storm Out of Studio.
Right. Straight up. I'm totally against Storm Out.
That is inappropriate. You
just
fucking
leave
the studio.
Fuck tight. Get out, Rob Mathias. Get fuck out.
That's unprofessional.
Can I put my headphones on first? Thank you.
Then you can't get
no,
out.
Can you imagine what it was like to watch that live?
Oh, man.
Oh, have Mark Edge storming in your kitchen. What do you do? Your boyfriend's an asshole.
A wild Mark Edge has appeared.
Mark Edge is kind of hot.
Okay, hold on. There might be a noise here. Yeah, unless I catch it. There we go.
Greek officials have threatened to default in recent weeks, arguing the country does not have
cash, which Eurozone Rob is not going to share his charger with you.
Just go grab it. It's right there. See that white cord?
Jesus.
Mary and Joseph.
FPP Radio News online at fppradio.com.
As of today, the average cost of a pack of cigarettes has gone up to two hand jobs and a stick of beef
jerky. Gosh.
Jesus fucking Christ.
People are knocking over the damn table.
We spent a lot of work.
I spent literally my entire day today setting up the studio, and you guys are just like throwing over a table like you're freaking... Now for what it's really like out there in the market. Whoa.
I never disrespected you.
I'm going to have to make a thread about this, about Renee Cake aggressing against my table.
People just throw this shit around, like, willy-nilly.
Right?
How dare Shardu? He aggressed against me. He took a picture and didn't Photoshop my name into it.
Snap. Oh, we're not going to bring that up, are we?
Just bring up all our haters, just one by one.
I actually...
Call them out. And you, motherfucker.
I don't know if you noticed, but a lot of my haters are featured in the finale of Shire Dude.
I noticed that.
Yeah.
Wait, I'm in the...
Welcome back to the show, and we always keep talking about Porkfest. Porkfest is coming up really soon, and Rebel Love Show, we're going to be recording there on Tuesday night at 10 p.m. at the Media Room, and then we're going to be on Friday at 3. I'm looking forward to the Friday episode, because that's kind of like the... Kind of like the recap right before the big gay dance party.
Can we talk about who we're having on Friday?
Absolutely. That's why I'm bringing it up.
Oh, my gosh. I'm excited because I've never met him before.
Neither have I.
And he's coming to New Hampshire for not the first time, right?
This is his first time coming to New Hampshire. First Porkfest.
And you're going
to
hear all of his excited puppy banter about, oh, my gosh, New Hampshire is the coolest.
Hopefully. Yeah. That's the plan.
Well, Porkfest is his first experience. He's going to be blown out of the water.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
So, Murdoch Biscotti... he's an activist down in Texas. He's does a lot of open carry events. He's like one of the founders of DontComply.com, and he also does Come and Take It Texas.
And he live streams on
Bamfuser. He live streams like open carry events and whatnot.
He actually live streams his activism, which mad props for that, because not enough people do that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, he also did, he took, back like at the beginning of the year, he took Cody Wilson's Ghost Gunner and was printing lower receivers on the state, like the steps of the state house in Texas.
That's what's up.
Like, that's hardcore.
Yeah.
Like, I wish people were doing stuff like that here in New Hampshire. So
you first.
So anyways, he's gonna be, I know. But yeah, he's going to be chilling with us the whole week and whatnot. We're going to show him around Porkfest. I'm excited about it. I've known him since like pretty much I entered like the activist world.
I mean,
like,
I don't,
from the beginning. So it's kind of, it's our paths haven't crossed yet, you know, but I've been talking to him for so long.
I don't know who we're going to have on the show. Only thing I know is we'll have on bikinis, definitely. And there's been talk of Jello wrestling as an alternative.
Jello wrestling?
Jello wrestling.
Really now?
Yeah.
Why would you guys jello wrestle?
Well, we won't jello, because people said that's how you should, you know, settle any disputes or
squash
beefs
the beef
that you
some
have
jello
with
wrestling.
Someone. So we're gonna invite everyone to jello wrestle, but only women.
To jello wrestle you guys or each other?
Hey, if you guys need an extra like cameraman in there,
I can't decide if we should do jello or we should just all grease each other up in the bathing suits. I don't know.
I'll grease you up. I'll grease both of you.
This might be the most exciting media room that Porkfest has ever had.
I know. We're going to bring the parties to the media room this year.
That's our goal, this edition size. Oh, we want to, you know, be like something you've never seen before.
So. I don't know if it was just me, but the media room last year seemed to be like my home base. You know, like I'd go back there to like charge my devices.
I had two spots I always hit religiously during Porkfest. One was at the Satoshi Saloon ran by Carlen Shem.
All right. Which is coming back.
Yes.
There's going to be another saloon.
I'm excited.
Mm-hmm.
And then, yes, the other one was the media room. So I always like made my rounds and always make sure I hit those two spots. Like,
right.
So this is my first Porkfest, but I did read the itinerary for last year's Porkfest because me and Rob were, you know, dating back then.
Uh-huh.
And you're going to be blown away. Like,
you have no idea.
We really can't do it justice just by talking about it. Yeah.
I know.
Take this past weekend and multiply it by like 100.
I'm very excited. Like, I feel like there's something that, you know, I just want to talk about, like, you know, I really want to choose, like, the right drug to do at Porkfest. I don't know if I want to do multiple or if I want to stick to one study drug to focus on, like mushrooms or LSD or it has to be something I've never tried before. Acid, I don't know if I really want to try acid. Should I do it still?
If you're going to do acid, I'd recommend doing it just in your hotel room and staying there. I wouldn't recommend doing it at
Porkfest. What would you recommend so that I'd enjoy the stars and be horny? Mushrooms. As a bunny.
Well, no, yes. Mushrooms aren't going to make you horny. Mushrooms are going to make you anti-horny.
Yeah. What about Molly?
If you do some Molly.
What if I pop a Molly? Will I sweat?
I'd recommend, but I'd recommend doing that during the Big Gay Dance Party.
A Molly?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm down, babe.
Certainly.
Okay.
Of course, I recommend doing it in like a really controlled environment before you go to Porkfest.
How does it make you feel? Like,
it makes music really awesome. It makes you very, very personable. So, like, you're going to want to, like, talk to people and tell them everything. It pushes you, like, really outwards, like, towards getting to know people. And you'll love dancing and whatnot. Just make sure to drink a lot of water and drink a lot of orange juice, you know.
Drink a lot of water and orange juice together.
Yeah, you want to get a lot of vitamin C.
That's going to be great. We're going to be body painting. It's going to be great.
That's the plan.
Wait, you guys are doing body painting for...
Yeah, that's what we're going to do.
Big A Dance Party? I didn't know this.
We've been kind of keeping it a secret. She's blowing her load right now.
All this over your face. This has been hush hush. Just like the creamy D. Hey, wait, guys, we need to talk about Renee's reaction to this.
Oh my God! During the break, we played the entire creamy D sex tape.
You may have noticed I haven't been talking much during this segment.
Ear raped Renee.
I'm a little traumatized.
And then at one point, we brought up the LRN feed. And we had Daryl Perry playing over it, and it was just gold.
Oh,
it was so gold.
That was great.
This is why you got to tune into the cam, folks. Don't just listen to us. Like,
wait, is that post in the Rebel Love Club?
The link for the live show is, but you know, anyone can go to rebelshow.com.
Where Creamy D posted, was that on your timeline?
No, that wasn't like in that club. No, that was on my own personal wall.
Okay. And he also posted it on the Shire Dude.
I think you guys should post that in the Rebel Love Club for those who would like to go back and listen to it.
Oh yeah, yeah. we'll have to reshare it there.
Believe me, you don't.
You do.
No, you
and
don't.
If you want to be part of the Rebel Love Club, you can go to facebook.com/rebel love club.
It won't be that. It'll be groups/rebel love club.
Yeah, groups.
Just type in Rebel Love Club on Facebook and you'll find us. And you should definitely be part of that. Because
we try to share some stuff on there that we only share in that group. So
you want to be special. Is Cecil in the Rebel Love Club? Is Renee even in the Rebel Love
Club? Yes.
Why?
She better be.
It's for our fans and lovers.
We like are the fucking Rebel Love Club.
We are the Rebel Love Club. That's so nice. Is that kind of like the what is it? That 80s show? Is it 80s?
That 70s Molly show.
That 70s show?
That 70s
what
show?
What the fuck are you talking
the
about?
The Breakfast Club.
I'm so confused.
Okay, that 70s show and The Breakfast Club are two different things.
Well, you said that 70s show. We are more like that 70s show.
We kind of are that 70s show,
Okay. Maybe.
Who's Don and who's Jackie?
You're definitely Jackie.
Is this table kind of like when they're smoking? Like during
the
show?
Oh, this is our round table.
I've had several people approach me about doing something like that, like a Shire Dude special like that or a show like that. And I'd love to do that where you just have the camera on a swivel in the middle of a group of people who are smoking weed.
Yeah.
That'd be a great format.
Maybe that we can do that and we can go over polyamory definitions.
Let's do it. And I'm totally down. Let's do that.
That'd be great content.
Yeah.
You know what I thought of, Shire Dude? If you're like vanilla, then I must be like non-fat frozen yogurt or like.
Whoa.
Wow.
I mean, I don't think Polly is inherently like kinky.
Scratch that. I'm like milk. I'm just the milk.
I don't know.
I'll be honest. I got a lot kinkier after I got into Polly, not the other way around. It's kind of fascinating because most people that get into poly come from the kink side.
Yeah, like me.
We're coming from like a whole.
I was on the kink side. Renee.
I have been kinked, man. Oh my God. This one
you
guy.
You have so much more
gorgeous.
Sex ahead of you.
This one guy. Yeah. Oh my God. Handcuffed me to the seat of my car.
Did someone film that? Then it didn't happen.
I wish because he was fucking beautiful. And if I could, like, ever, like, if I could just take it,
Where was the craziest place you've had sex?
Oh, you can go first, Shire, dude. That's a good question.
Sure. In an alley. It was completely outdoors, and it was like the middle of daytime. I got a blowjob.
Oh.
Yeah. Broad daylight, and I was sitting against a brick wall in an alley.
Classy.
Actually, really, really close to the street.
That is so classy. Was she, did you know her before then, or?
Yeah, we were together.
Oh, was she hot?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Oh, and it was just time.
I mean, who isn't hot if they're giving you a blowjob in the middle of an alley?
She lived in the back of the alley, but for some reason, we did it in totally like the front of the alley, like right near the street.
Like, you guys can wait. She was like, I have to.
YOLO.
And I'm hoping that you guys can beat me with this story because, I mean, it's not, I mean, it's exciting. It's outdoors sex, but it's not that exciting. So hopefully we have
that. I got some exciting stuff.
I'll check my list.
I'll come up with something good.
Coming up.
On LRN.FM, we talk a lot about alternative currencies. Did you know that now you can buy gold?
Can you turn down Ian talking about gold and shit?
Sorry.
Great.
I've had some crazy sex. Like, I don't even... like, I don't know which...
Can we can we listen to something really fast?
What do you want to listen to?
I think this audio is going to work. I'm pretty sure.
Oh, my God.
Okay, so this is the rap that went out over my live stream. Let's see if I can do this here.
Oh,
there he is.
Oh, shit.
One too many lies. In the cries of the past, the herd is the future dies. And they all try to hold back the tides by closing their eyes, folding their hands, and talking to the skies, tying a knot for their own noose, letting their own killer loose, poisoning their own juice, licking different symbols on the same jackfruit formed by gangsters in a modern suit. Who traded all our assets for debt and left on private jets? And we're too dumb to have regret. Place your bet. How long will it last before that cash in your pocket is only good for wiping ass? Struggling to put the blame or whatever name you can remember. Come the first Monday of November. But when the boys in blue point their guns at you, the true nature of the beast shines through.
That was awesome. That was great. Right here.
Chances of
that.
Cool.
That was a fun night.
That was great.
Whenever the Onion plays, I always think that's the break. Anyways, what we come back with?
Including details on how to
get a free sex stories?
Yeah, I guess. We kind of set that up, guys.
What's a sex story?
You have to tell...
Your kinkiest sex story, or... Your, I don't know. I think it was like, where's the craziest place you had sex?
Yeah, craziest, kinkiest, whatever.
I mean, you know.
It has to be interesting.
What if the key to achieving liberty?
I need a show clock. I need a show clock.
Gosh.
You can just listen.
I need a show clock.
Bitch ass motherfucker. Like the entire episode. Gosh, man. Can somebody buy this man a show clock? Goodness gracious. And are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation.
We can talk about some places we've had sex, babe.
That's not what the story is supposed to be about.
No, kinkiest,
kinkiest place you've
craziest,
had sex.
Craziest, craziest spot was in front of a couple of people.
For you?
For me, that's my craziest spot. I don't know if I bring that up. Nah, I can't do that. Each week. See what's happening at
freekeen.com and get connected with video, audio, video, free books, audio, forum, free books,
activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeen.com. That's freekeen.com.
Instead of just listening, you can also watch. See the Liberty Radio Network's Keene, New Hampshire-based live shows via our studio cam at cam.lrn.fm. Plus, you'll still be able to listen to the Liberty Radio Network via the cam feed in high quality 24/7, even when there's no live show being produced in our Keene studio. But wait, there's more. Our chat room is built into the cam page so you can interact with other listeners online. Listen, watch, and chat.
What are you guys doing over there?
I got a good one.
Renee's angry at the table.
Gosh!
LRN.fm.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime.
I need a show clock.
Yeah, you need a show clock like hardcore, especially since like you're smoking and have no concept of time right now.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to put the times.
Where's the bomb?
I know, pass it. I want to put the times right here at the bottom of the computer. So, like, I'll see the time on the clock, and that way I can know when the breaks come and go.
Uh-huh.
I got this.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.FM.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And we were all telling, well, Shire, you started off this circle, and I guess we'll continue it from the break, which we normally don't do in this show.
We were talking about the craziest place you've had sex,
yes,
right?
Yes, the craziest place we've had sex.
I don't know how this came up, but I want to keep with it.
Okay. Well, you know what, my world mistress, how about you go first?
No, you go first. Stop trying to get out of this.
I have a crazy story. It's probably the craziest one, but it's not in like a craziest place. But it was with multiple people in the house.
It was just in front of people?
No. Okay, so my ex from, God, well, I'm obviously ex now, but this is like 5 years ago. It was someone I used to see on and off again for years. And she was a loud one. And we got back together. And I was staying with a friend at the time. I was living with them, him and his like estranged wife, and we were really, really loud, and we didn't care if they were home or not. And so what they did was they decided to give us a soundtrack. All right. So literally for like an hour, they just kept playing different sex songs. Like every sex song you can imagine that had sex in it.
That's a good roommate. Shire, did you never do that
for us? I know. I want to play us a soundtrack while we're having sex.
No. Yeah, no. Sometimes I play music over you guys, but that's about it.
Oh.
Aww.
I don't know. I'd like to think most of the music I listen to is pretty sexy anyway.
Yeah, that's true.
You do have good musical taste.
You're a sexy beast.
Thank you.
Like, you've turned me on to a lot of great music.
Oh, right? Like, yeah. Recently, what was it? Don't Want to Fight by Alan.
No. I introduced you to that. It played on my Pandora station.
But I was the one who said this is a great song.
No, I already knew it was a great song. I had heard it multiple times
but
on that
station.
But
it really, it took me to be in the room to recognize
I think
no.
so.
The greatness
without
of the song.
Shire Dude, you never would have recognized.
Same thing as on Glass Animals. Now, I played it for you. You'd heard it before, but then
I
you
knew
realized...
That was a good...
Then you realize you're like,
that's not
yeah.
true at
oh
all.
My god!
This
and
is a great song.
From that point on, Rob became a hipster. Turned Rob into a hipster. When I met him, he was all about that rock and roll. Now he's like,
babe, I keep changing. I keep evolving.
He's evolving.
You gotta listen to that.
I like
Mindy.
New experiences.
Okay, I didn't tell my story.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, please do.
Okay, so I don't know. There's been a lot of times. I'm gonna say the weirdest time because. Just like Rob is kind of bizarre. It was my first time coming to New Hampshire.
Oh boy.
I've heard this story multiple times.
It was my birthday. And I was seeing this couple. We were dating, you know, nothing too serious. But you know, whatevs. I hadn't been to New Hampshire. They wanted to take me up. I got super drunk even though it was my 20th birthday. And I rolled in the car with them back to New Hampshire just on a whim. Like, I had to work the next morning. I didn't have any clothes and just, like, this slutty dress. And me and the guy start engaging in some sexual activity on the car ride to New Hampshire. And then the girlfriend joined. I'm sitting in the back seat. They're in the front seat. You can imagine what's going on. And I get all the way to New Hampshire and then just have this crazy, amazing... Like, well, it was okay. Well, the girl was pretty good. The guy was like, eh. Anyway, I had this, like, just threesome on my birthday, just on a whim, and it was my first experience in New Hampshire. So I feel like that was, like, the craziest time I've had sex. Though, me and Rob try to top it every time.
Oh, yes, we've topped it a couple of times. There are some very memorable moments. I have a lot of them. I don't want to share them because they involve other people, but.
Good God.
Oh, my God.
All right, Renee, you're up.
Renee, you're up.
Well.
Unless you want me to go in more detail, which I don't think you do.
Anyways. I don't know. I can't really pick one. I'm, like, looking through my list and, like, trying to think of, like, you know, good times.
Okay, her list. Can we pause? Who? I think it's crazy. Like, I think it's important to know who you're sleeping with. But I think it's crazy to literally write out, like, in numbered order. Well, I guess, never mind, because Shirey's fucking poly tree, Eskimo family tree. You guys are crazy. You guys don't need that information.
Look, there's a lot of people on that Eskimo family tree.
That information is very important.
This is good. Shire Dude wouldn't have such a filled out family tree had I not completed this list.
Yeah, thank you.
I would have forgot.
Yeah, that's true.
And I don't, like, I'm forgetful. I just want to remember, like, who I fucked. And, like, if I can't remember fucking you, then, that's too bad. But, anyways. So, one of my exes, we were at a music fest. And we were hooking up in the tent. And this tent was kind of, like, poorly put together. And my back was turned to the side that fell down. But the tent fucking fell down. And apparently our friends were, like, screaming to us, like, hey, everybody can see you guys having sex. But I was tuning them out. Wow. I was too focused on what I was doing.
Was that with Ian Freeman and Titu?
No, okay. It was not. Sexy half-black boyfriend. Anyways, yeah, he could hear them, but, like, just didn't care. And then the next thing you know, we've got, like, this crazy bitch screaming at us, there are children here! And I turn around and I'm like, what the fuck? And then I was like, oh! And then, wow. Like... jumped off and, like, covered myself and then walked out, like, why did nobody say anything? And they were like, we did. You ignored us. And I was like, oh.
See, if I seen that, I wouldn't even bother.
Were you, like, impaired somehow? Like,
no, I just wasn't. I was, like, too zoned in into what I was doing.
Wow. Wait, what position were you in?
I was on top. And my back was turned to the tent, like, where it fell down. Had it been in front, I would have seen it. But since it was behind me, I was just like, you know. Let's see, what else?
you can tell more than one.
Well, this guy had a pickup truck, and he had, like, one of those cabs that went over it, and he had, like, a built-in, like, bed. It was pretty cool.
I hate having sex in cars.
Are, like, you reading this off of your phone right now?
I looked through the Renee list and I'm like, archives. Yeah, kind of.
What is going on right now?
One guy on prom night, this is actually pretty funny. We were hooking up in some stranger's bathroom. I still don't fucking know whose bathroom that was.
That's typical prom.
And we tried to get in the shower, like, we were fucking on the sink. We tried to get in the shower, but we couldn't get the shower to work.
Wow.
I fucked in the bathroom on my prom too, because we had some people who wouldn't get the fuck out of the room. Like, they wanted to stay and hang out. Like, they just weren't getting it. So we just did it in the bathroom.
And this is this is a good one. So the same music fest last year.
Again? They let you come back?
There was this really hot guy that I was, like, you know, too scared to talk to in high school. But he came up to me, offered me some water. And, you know, we were talking. And then we were like, hey, let's go drink by the river. We ended up hooking up by the river. And in Vermont, beautiful at night. No light pollution, all the stars on a beach by the river. Great temperature. It was great. We fucked right there. And it was beautiful. And I was beautiful. let's see. What else? Ooh, the sexy guy I was talking about before, the one that I will never forget. Like, I wish I had, like, some kind of fucking medal for hooking up with him. I deserve one. First time we hooked up. We pulled into a parking lot, I believe it was the Target parking lot in Keene, and hooked up in my car.
Well, there you go.
Yep. And then the rest just ranged from outrageous, dirty dorm rooms, hotel rooms.
Yeah.
She just...
holy smokes.
Blew us out of the water there, folks.
Well, I've got a lot, man. Well, don't take that the wrong way. Just great stories. I make it
good. More sex stories when we come back, folks.
Okay. Since time began, tyrants
have taken personal liberties. What are we talking about next? We got two more segments. What do you kids want to talk about?
The government has no more right.
I mean, I can go back
to
bread and butter.
In our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six movers party next week. I will live stream walkthrough of Pork Fest.
Today, many cops
well, people want to see at Pork Fest so if they're to walk through. They're not going jobs, to Pork Fest.
Good benefits and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
That's pretty much
the
all
Second
I got,
Amendment
man.
Says you got to keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film
who?
By Michael W. D.
Oh my God, why do I have the LRN feed up? Jesus. I keep forgetting I can turn that down.
The kid who's 4 and he's going to be circumcised because his dad's a dick. Makes the perfect gift.
Remember, that's guns. They're going to cut his penis at age 4?
Yes, and he doesn't want to be cut, but his dad's insisting upon it.
And they threaten to take the kid away from the mom.
And they put the mom in jail.
Or they did take her away.
Yes. And they put her in jail, and the only way they would let her out of jail is by her signing a consent waiver for him to get his dick cut, so she sold out.
Well, that's really off topic from what we just went. We can talk about circumcised dicks in the answers.
We are open to what do we prefer, circumcised, uncircumcised?
We want to learn from each other.
Sexual preferences.
And its diverse members.
Sex. Love. Speaking of, as well. There are many I sold out. I suck.
One I know.
But I turned up the icebox first. Free Church does not call me Elsa. Path
someone just joined? Cool.
You didn't tell me about peace those. Your way. What? Love as your guide and liberty
as your light. Learn more at church.shiresociety.com. Oh, hey, I gotta show you what,
That's church.shiresociety.com.
What are you doing over there?
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Toll House Morsels, helping you create special moments and memories your family will cherish forever. Visit us at
Toll House. Ian just gave me a show clock.
Ian's like, you didn't tell me about this. What the fuck? I tell you about every family
to one of their favorites or to surprise them with something new. Either way, you'll create a tradition everyone will
love. Even better question.
For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The three most important things you can do for LRN.FM are 1. Let your friends know you're listening to LRN.FM.
Anyways, yeah, I just wanted to share the bottom part.
That's nice.
2. Buy the things you buy online through shop.lrn.fm. 3. Give $5 a month
to the AMP program at amp.lrn.fm. You know, it's interesting. We don't have any kind of AMP program or really bonus content.
If you want to AMP me, give me some Bitcoin.
Newbie904 said there wasn't much kink in sexy poly stories. Newbie, what's your name again? Newbie.
How kinky?
904. You got to tune into Seditious Sirens if you want me to get really kinky. Sorry.
Yeah. What am I doing? Do this right now. We need more pot. Like me. Well, babe, can you pack that?
I guess I can get more pot.
Everything around here.
Look, I did the whole THC cleanse thing, and then like a few hits later, I was back to normal.
Kids, don't stop doing drugs. All right, take my word for it. It ain't worth it.
Yeah, just keep doing drugs, I think it's the lesson learned.
According to Dave, really, this has become the hippie movement.
You idiot. Ian's like, you didn't tell me about the guy you hooked up with at the festival. I'm like, no, we were together, you fucking idiot. God.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And like we've been talking about this whole week, this whole episode, not whole episode, most episode, Pork Fest is coming up.
Right.
All
right.
And this is going to be Anne's first Pork Fest.
And I'm going to be, I got my VIP ticket, very important, Porcupine.
Yeah, and if you haven't gotten your Pork Fest tickets yet, get your Pork Fest tickets. Go VIP it. It's worth it for just the drinks, believe me. That's the only reason why I'm getting this, because I would have spent more money on alcohol than the price of that ticket. So
I wouldn't. Rob just insisted.
Oh, well, babe, we're ballers. We got to ball it up now.
Yeah, that's true.
But at Pork Fest, we've been kind of talking about the idea of a live stream / walkthrough
right.
of Porkfest.
There's so many things that like you could really do during Porkfest, and there's like the pressure is on right now.
Yeah.
You got to figure out, you know, what is it you're going to do during this week? This is the biggest week of our year.
Yeah. No, it's
what
our...
is this, our season finale? Our season... like, what is it? I think it's going to be our season finale, and then we'll start a new season.
Perhaps.
No, it will be our series finale, yeah. Yeah. Our season finale.
Season.
Not
our
series.
Season.
No,
our
season,
series
yeah.
Gonna
season over. 5 is going to be a very short-lived season. All right. This is season 5 right now. We're almost, we're coming up near the end of it.
I feel like we've been in season 5. When did season 5 start?
Oh, season 5 started a couple episodes ago.
What?
Yeah.
Dude, no, you can't end season 5 till we get the Rebel Love pad.
No. That's not going to happen until the end of season 6. This is Shire years.
Okay, no. Okay, yeah.
Our seasons last in Shire years.
No, this is ridiculous. No. If you can't keep shortening the Shire years.
No, if after, okay, after Porkfest will be our season finale.
Yes.
And our season premiere will obviously start when we move.
The new season, yes, but that will be the start of season 6.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's close enough.
But what she's saying, what the Rebel Love Pad, you know, when we get, you know, we're outgrowing the studio, we will expand. We're all gonna get a new place together. But Renee, that ain't gonna happen for at least another Shire year, and
no.
That's probably the season premiere of season 7.
No.
Yeah.
Dude.
I think it'll be this. I don't know.
A lot can happen in the next season.
You never know what could happen. One of us could get a boob job.
No.
I might. I don't know.
I know. I my money's on Shire D, but we never know.
You guys, we have a special listener.
Who's our special listener?
Jazzy the studio dog is listening.
Aww.
I got
Hi, Jazzy.
Her little ears are perked up. Jazzy!
Oh, that's
Bye.
Cute.
Aww.
Oh, and Ash fucking Ash is out. She's like, fuck you.
Speaking of, make sure you go like Ash the studio cat.
And Jazzy the studio dog.
There. He's the co-producer. When are you guys gonna let Jazzy be a co-producer of the Rebel Love Show?
We don't need a co-producer.
She needs to move to Manchester to do that. Come on now.
Well, yeah. Fuck you. She can be a producer of the Seditious Sirens any day.
Ash is already the producer of the Seditious Sirens.
Yo,
you can have
yourself.
A co-producer.
Jazzy's way better.
Jazzy's
the producer of Free Talk Live. That's a nationally syndicated fucking
Whoa.
Show.
Whoa.
She just pulled
Shots
rank on
fired.
Us. She just pulled rank on us. That's not the first
Jazzy's
time.
Jazzy's a cop block dog. She's a Liberty in North
coming
Korea.
From the coming from the
dog.
Person that wore high heels to a cop block. I mean, I expected a little bit more from
Jazzy
a Keniac.
Gets more flyers handed out than anybody I know. She gets all the people to stop because she's kind of like a therapy dog, too, you know? She's been to nursing homes. She, Jazzy has like 5 million up on Ash, man. Ash, love you.
How many likes does she have on Facebook?
Yeah, that's what counts as
I'm just
Facebook
being a double.
Dude, I don't give a fuck how many likes she has. It's something like 50-ish, whatever.
Okay, guys, go
awesome.
Like Jazzy the studio dog.
I think Ash has like more than double those likes.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
When was the last time your cat did community service?
Community service?
I know. Ash is a lazy activist.
Anyone that comes over here, they can take all the aggression they have toward whoever they have drama with, and they just spank the hell out of
spank
Ash.
Spank Ash, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, my
Ash
God.
Is a battered housewife. Jazzy is,
she
like
is
a hero.
No. She's not a battered housewife. She loves being battered.
She's a BDSM.
She does. It's weird. Seriously, she's getting spanked right now, and she loves every.
Oh yeah, she's like grabbing the chair. Yeah,
it's
yeah,
the
yeah.
weirdest thing I've ever seen.
Is that the kinkiest thing? Like, I mean, look, that's what I'm. Is that the kinkiest thing you're into? That's Ash's spanking.
Ash spanking, yes.
Shire,
Ash
dude,
love...
I really want to know what's the kinkiest
you
thing that you're
spank her
into.
A lot.
Whoa,
you're spanking her right now.
I know. It yeah. seems like you like to.
We need to get a special camera just for Ash. I think if we get a fifth camera for the studio, we're gonna have it on Ash.
A fifth camera on Ash.
The kitty cam.
Hashtag cat cam.
Because she's actually sitting for the people who aren't here, obviously, she's sitting in a chair next to me. We actually have a specific chair for her.
We should have the camera on Ash, which is then superimposed on the green screen behind
oh,
us.
Oh, there you go.
So Ash is just laying there getting spanked right
giant,
behind us.
Instead of a DMT trip, just a giant fucking
we actually haven't been
video
using,
of
we,
Ash being spanked.
Babe.
Yeah.
You're in us for a surprise. We haven't been using that angle for most of this episode.
Most of the episode is actually you guys behind us.
Yeah. So we're all just looking straight. It's really awkward. It's kind of weird. I'm looking at you, and then you're looking right back at me, behind me, on the screen.
Really?
It's very trippy. Yes.
Oh.
Awkward. Yeah.
That's crazy.
Well, I like to be able to see all of us in one shot. It makes my job as a cameraman easier.
I don't understand why he flips these shots, but they're really hysterical.
He's doing things like how he sees the world. Because Shire Jesus.
Oh, yeah. You should see that.
You mean Shire Jesus.
Oh, the part where he focused in on you guys telling your sex stories. Oh, the magic he did. Oh, my God.
A sex story.
Great.
I just want to sound, I aim to sound like the Creamy D's sex tape.
No. No. Those bitches sounded like Yoko Ono, first of all.
What's wrong with that?
I know. She's hot.
No. I ever fuck a bitch that sounds like Yoko. Nope. Or him. Like, no offense, man. Like, he's awesome, but still.
Can you give us a demonstration of how you're supposed to sound?
Wait, are you guys going to release a sex tape?
A Seditious Siren sex tape.
No, I'm going to get some audio of me having good sex, and I'll release it.
And then
it.
I'll get good audio, and then we'll merge them, and that'll be the intro.
You know what you should do? You should start a GoFundMe campaign for releasing a sex tape on Seditious Sirens.
Well, then Shire Dude will have to film it and then extort this.
Wow.
Guys, when I say this, I'm really joking, because there's some people who don't have common sense.
Bitches.
So that's it, period. Okay, yeah, now what are we talking about?
it's kind of amazing how that kind of drama unfolded, but...
Yeah.
No, it's not. She's fucking stupid, okay?
There's so much drama.
I think, yeah. I mean,
everyone's breaking out of cabin fever.
I think the individual who accused me of extortion and theft really knows what extortion and theft is and was being dishonest.
Spell extortion and theft is what you...
Well, she kind of went off the deep end when she started like sharing like Anne's statuses about me and Anne.
Yeah.
That was a little weird.
She started sharing it, saying, oh, look, they're going on a vacation, but she threatened to kill me over $20.
And I paid her.
I know.
I actually sent her Bitcoin. I sent her a screenshot,
and
she said,
that.
Thank you.
I literally posted, like, all of our messages, even the message where you asked her repeatedly what something was, and people were still like, oh, well, that doesn't matter anymore.
Like, now, this brings up an interesting point. Like, I know there's a lot of drama in Manch, and a lot of people say, well, don't you anarchist, libertarian, voluntarists have a peaceful arbitration and mediation that you can go to? Why is there so much drama when you have that? And here's the thing is, that stuff doesn't solve all the drama.
No, it definitely doesn't solve all the drama.
Especially when people are just crazy.
Like,
sorry.
Especially when certain people realize that if they're in the wrong or if they have no way to prove their claims, they realize that just going public is a way to drag your opponent's reputation through the mud.
Yeah, because no one cares about the truth at that point. They only care about heating up the drama, pumping into it. Like, they don't care, like, what really happened. Like, you can try to explain it a million times. You can post all the logical pictures. People don't care. They just want to see the drama.
Well, like, with this studio and whatnot, we had drama and whatnot that wasn't... That never went public. Like,
I mean,
that never
but
was,
the
like,
people
but
who know about it in this community can still dislike you,
well,
even
yeah,
if
absolutely.
You show them that contract
like,
on your wall.
Big difference between going public and like actually working out between
it's
like
a, yeah it's a know. Classic politician's move. It's I say hey Rob, what about those children you raped? And then all of a sudden the discussion is Rob raping children.
That's it. That's all it's gonna be
right,
about now.
Boom. It's like the accusation creates this whole controversy.
Please don't quote that.
More yeah
mediation
more
talk when
the,
we come back.
Yeah, more on the drama when we come back.
Speaking of, is how porn recorded. Oh shit.
Liberty and property is what the free
I was trying to mute it fast enough
having,
and I couldn't get my fingers there.
Fuck. Oh well. I'm sure he won't be mad. Is it child porn to record audio of a 17-year-old having sex? Probably not, right?
Record audio?
Yeah.
I mean,
because you can't prove anything.
The state is retarded. They don't care.
Yeah. How, yeah.
You can't prove it.
You can't prove who it is.
Yeah.
You can't prove it is actual sex.
And how can you tell by someone's voice if they're 17? That's like so stupid.
So
how can you tell who they are if they're, you know, it's just audio? Could just be a really good impression.
Right, and do you have sex videos of Renee?
No.
Release them.
No.
Send Ian all your touch.
Believe me.
Hey, hand me the bomb, baby doll.
He's been saving you for
years. Baby doll. Oh, no. I didn't mean you to smoke it. I meant you to hand it to me.
Wow. What the fuck?
What? Yeah, hey, thanks. We changed the entire format. I don't know if you've seen the new angles and everything, but we've changed the entire format at the studio.
I like the way it looks.
We moved the table just last night, and then I adjusted. I spent all day adjusting the camera angles. I'm still going to have to adjust them a bit more, though. There's
and the lighting's coming in, so we gotta get that all hooked up.
Yeah, we've actually got lighting coming in. I think the lighting's gonna fix a lot of our visual issues.
When did you
like professional style lighting, man? I actually, yeah, Rob has sank a lot of money into the studio. I mean, just lighting alone, it's you know, this is our passion.
Well,
we're
a team.
Yeah, me and my baby dollar team. But yeah, this is my passion. This studio, this activism, you know. Like, I love this. Like, I'm living like a dream, man. This has been a crazy year.
So, when did people start talking about domestic violence in the chat? Because the only thing I hear is, when did you quit beating your wife when she learned her goddamn lesson? It's a little aggressive, people. It's a common faux pas you'll want
to avoid, especially if you're a job seeker. I see FTL Ian in the chat room. Oh my gosh. Hey, guys, I should share this with you. I had a nightmare last night.
Oh my God.
I had a nightmare last night that I had started my own LRN show, like a Shire Dude LRN show. And like something like screwed up on my computer and like LRN had dead air. And then like I saw like I was like talking to Ian. Like right after, and he was like, "Yeah, we had dead air," and I was like so disappointed in myself in this nightmare. Guys, I think the lesson learned is just don't start a podcast. Really,
don't
start a band. Don't.
It's
start
so
a band.
You sink so much time and effort into this. It consumes.
Yeah. That's the weirdest nightmare, though.
Yeah, that is pretty weird. That sounds like equivalent to you standing in a classroom naked.
Kind
of,
yeah.
In front of everyone.
Well, it's like, you know. It's the pre-show nightmare. That's where LRN.FM comes in. Learn more at broadcast.LRN.FM. That's
broadcast.LRN.FM. If you want to move to the free state.
God,
so can we buy Rob Mathias a show clock?
No, he gave me
a
show clock. Ian sent it to me. I haven't opened it yet.
Muting us.
I'm just going to
randomly.
I'm just going to put the times right here on the computer. I'll have that done probably in like 3 weeks. Maybe four tops.
Call Mark Warden.
Mark Warden's such a good guy. I know, babe. He's a silver fox. Mark Warden.
That guy's hot. Silver Fox.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, and here at the last segment of the episode, kind of going to dip back to the idea of doing a live stream walkthrough with Porkfest. Like, what would you, if you weren't going to Porkfest, which you really should, you really should be going to Porkfest, but if you weren't going to Porkfest and you just couldn't make it, but you wanted to see like what it would be like just walking around, like where do you want to go? Where do you want to see?
Well, you can actually look up the schedule,
yeah.
Right? What is it like?
Oh yeah, we can have like a, you know,
porkfest.com. You should be able to get to the
yeah,
schedule.
The schedule is there. Yeah, we can actually see what people really want us to go to that aren't there.
Yeah,
and we can like walk around going to that event or whatnot or what have you.
Certainly,
I think you should do. Isn't someone gonna do like a hyper, like when it's like really speeded, like put the video?
They're gonna do a time lapse, yeah, of the entire event or
that
something like that.
That is gonna be so awesome.
Yeah, that's gonna be pretty cool.
See, well, here's what I'm thinking. All right, because during the last DUI checkpoint, I took a lot of video. I took video with my Sony Handycam, but I also took video with my cell phone. I'm rocking a Galaxy S6, which the camera on there just like is mind-blowingly better than my Sony Handycam.
Right.
You know, and I'm dropping too much money on this to like this studio to like afford to buy like a really nice camera. I'm like, I'm not
camcorder. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not made of money.
You might as well just stick with your awesome cell phone.
Yes. So I think I've joked about it, but I'm actually giving it contemplating it is just getting one of those Bluetooth monopods.
Right.
You know, as a selfie stick. I'd like do live stream for like hop locks and stuff like, because I can hold it up high and like get a good angle of like a crowd or something like that. You know,
what I really want to get is like a wide angle lens for my cell phone and, you know, snap that on there. And then I don't know, maybe use a tripod or drive in a car or something and get really long shots and then we can put them on the screen.
Yes.
If you drive in the car, will you drive drunk?
No.
All around?
Oh. Audience, the chat room, if you're watching on rubberloveshow.com, what would you want to see in the green screen behind us?
Shire dude and
like,
drag.
We'll, if there's enough popular demand, we'll do it.
Yeah. Shire dude and drag.
What, just jumping around in the back or something?
Oh,
dancing?
Just like model walking back and forth.
No more dick gay.
Dick gay.
Oh
my God,
dude's
please.
Dick in drag.
That was disgusting.
Yeah, but Shire dude fixed that with his Shire D.
I didn't go, okay, so if you don't know about the story, because they're so inside baseball, someone posted a picture of their dick somehow. Anyway, that's a short version of the story.
That's a very short version.
Yeah. Someone posted a picture of their dick somewhere, and now they're calling it Dickgate. Hashtag Dickgate.
And it's gross.
I was never tempted to look at this picture ever.
You think it's Photoshopped?
I don't think it's Photoshopped.
Why would someone Photoshop their penis? Was it big?
Oh, to make it look bigger.
He probably has a big dick.
He did.
Dude,
I actually believe the photo. I
believe the photo.
I
believe it's a huge cock.
I don't believe it.
I believe that photo.
Look, I have hung out with him a bunch, okay?
Have you seen his dick?
Have you seen his dick?
No, I have not.
Okay, then, Michael Jackson. Like, if you're not going to describe it to me.
Look, sometimes
they shrink like a frightened turtle.
Yeah.
Look,
all right?
I have never been surprised by somebody's dick, okay? I hang around you long enough, I already know what your dick looks like. Okay?
How does Rob's penis look? Describe it in detail.
What?
Yeah, I want to know if she knows.
No, I don't know.
Okay, then you don't know how big his actual dick was. If someone's going to waste the time to Photoshop a picture of their dick, you got a lot of time
on your hands.
And
why would she lie about the size, people?
Anyway, you get, first of all, I think you can tell by their voice. If you look at their hands or their feet.
No, Rob has small
or
hands. I have large feet, though.
By their personalities, you can tell, like, what kind
you
of hormones are going.
You cannot tell by someone's personality. I'm going to tell you my small dick story. Okay, it was Halloween.
Uh-oh.
It was Halloween 2014, pre-convention. And I decided to go on this date with this guy that I met on Tinder. And long story short, I went home with the guy because why the hell not?
Long story short.
Yeah, exactly. Really short.
Not so long.
So anyway.
Oh, no.
Like, we're like lying there and then he starts trying to kiss me. And then I'm like, am I feeling him?
I feel that.
You know, I'll just make out with him a little more. Why not? And then, so like, he's like grinding on me or whatever, but I don't feel anything. So I think, you know, sometimes guys' penises aren't like always up front, so you never know. He got like we were still I still had on all my clothes, but he got like down to his boxers, like that was gonna encourage me more. But I was still at a point where, you know, either if I could leave or like make either or decision in case I don't want to sleep with him or I do. So he started kissing me more, and then he like pulls down his pants, and I swear, there's this guy. First of all, before I get to that part, he was the tallest guy ever. He was like 6'10". Like, his head, like, so tall. Oh my God. He had red hair and like this ginger beard. Like, typical, like.
That's not a good sign.
No, this guy looked like a fucking basketball player. Like, he had size 14, like, hands and size 32 feet.
Was he skinny?
No. He used to be a football player. Like,
okay.
This,
all right.
This guy.
All right. Now we're getting somewhere.
This guy. I know guys have small penises. And maybe before this guy, I had I had more of an expectation. Like, I was thinking, like, if you're like 5 inches, that's a little small. But this guy, he pulled down his pants. And I swear to you, it looked like a shiitake mushroom. But he had the ginormous cojones Like, they were hanging all the way down to, like, his knees with no penis. Like, his penis looked like a large clit. And I was like, my first thought, I should get this on Snapchat. People are not going to believe this story. I wanted to take a picture of it. And I seen that. And guys, you might think I'm mean for this, but he started being kind of a dick. I was like, you know, I'm not really interested in pursuing this. And then he was like, oh, man. Like, why not? Like, I bought you dinner. And, like, he kept, like, pressing it on. I was like, you know, I just really like to go home.
It's not your dick or anything.
I have school in the morning.
Yeah, that's it.
It was like Friday. I was like, I have school in the morning. And he was like, oh my God, like, please just stay. Like, if you blow mine, I'll blow yours. And I was
begging,
like,
is so unattractive.
He was begging, first of all. Oh, and confidence is everything. Yeah. But he was like, what was I gonna put my mouth? Where was I gonna put my mouth? There was like nothing there, I swear. Like, I don't know if he wanted me to pretend. I don't know what happened.
And he was totally hard.
Yeah.
Damn.
Like, at first, like, when I seen it, I was like, maybe he's not. But, like, it was literally smaller than a baby's dick.
Now I want to say, how do you know what baby dick looks like?
I've changed diapers. Oh.
That was hardcore. All right, so Seditious Sirens, where can people find
SeditiousSirens.com? But we're, like, still working on the whole website. Yeah,
We're close.
What's gonna happen with that?
You've seen it. What? I started it.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Is there something up when I go to SeditiousSirens.com?
Yes, of course.
I transferred it
to the Facebook page because I was like, oh, I'll build a website eventually.
At least I got it redirected.
So it's redirected.
I'm going to go to it right now, actually.
You can find us on YouTube. We're on Twitter. Boom. We never tweet.
Oh,
Twitter.
That's cool.
We tweet sometimes.
Fuck Twitter.
I tweet. I have it connected.
But we're, like, all over Facebook and YouTube and shit. So.
Yeah, and if you want some Renee boxes of cigarettes, you can find our Bitcoin
imports, because, like, yeah, things
please,
are harder.
People, she needs them bad. Like it's need, all about those cigarettes.
By the way, who wants to buy me cigarettes after the show?
God damn, I'm out.
Jesus fucking. But anyway, yep, look for us, like us on Facebook, subscribe to our YouTube channel. That way, you know, we can get our own domain name, which would be awesome.
You got it, babe. It's already there. You just need your own website going.
We're working on it.
No, you have to get 500 subscribers now.
What?
Yeah.
What are you talking about?
For your YouTube handle to be Seditious Sirens.
Oh, what you're talking about fuck? That.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. You have to get 500 now.
What? Since
no.
when?
I wouldn't lie.
No, that's bullshit, because I set up the YouTube.
Nope. When you click on it, it doesn't. The URL is just like this chunky thing. It's not Seditious Sirens.
What?
I set it up as youtube.com/Seditious I'm sure Sirens, so that's bullshit.
Okay.
We'll
it fucking
check it
better
afterwards.
Be. We'll check on it, but it better be. Otherwise, I'm going to be pissed.
Yeah, I would be too. I'm for sure
pissed.
It is. I wouldn't worry about it.
So
and what about you, Shire, dude? Where can all the fine young people out there find you at?
All the fine young people who
have lots of sex and body hair can find me everywhere.
At ShireDude.com. All my work is right there, and it's pretty fantastic.
Watch out for his body rolls, though.
Whoa.
You don't get it?
And you can find the Rebel Love Show at rebelloveshow.com. And maybe one day there will be some sex videotape on there. An audio, great audio form. Peace.
Peace.
Deuces.
All right.